Hello everyone. Now let us look at the next problem here, and this next problem is actually very similar to the previous problem that we have already discussed. And again, the time constraint here is that we have to solve this problem in order of n time, and the space complexity should be order of 1. So the solution that we are looking here, we should have just hold on a second. So in the solution we should have time complexity as order of n and space complexity should be order of 1. So what they are saying is, you are given an array of n plus 2 integer elements. All elements in the array are in range from 1 to n. And all elements occur once except two numbers which occur twice. So what they are saying is that we have a range 1 to n. So n can be anything. Let us say we have n is 5. So 1 to 5. We are assuming that n is 5. And we'll be having an array, assuming that this is the array. And this array is having a total of n plus 2 index locations. So if n is 5, therefore this array will be having a total of 7 index locations. From here to here, it will be having a total of 7 index locations. And all the numbers that is 1 to 5, they will be in this array. So let us assume the numbers are 1, 2, 4, 3, 5, again 1. And here we have the number 3. So these are total 7 numbers that we have. Okay. I hope that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So total 7 numbers that we have. Now in these numbers, there are two numbers that are repeating itself. As you can see here, number 3 is coming here as well as it is also coming here. At the same time, number 1 is coming here as well as it is also coming here. So there are two numbers that must be repeating itself. Now our job is to write a program that will solve this problem in order of n as a time complexity or order of 1 as a space complexity. And we have to find those two numbers that are repeating itself, correct? And here they are giving us how the input should be given and how the output should be given. And I'm going to ignore this because I think I've explained you many times what is the input and output format. So I'm just going to skip this part and let us look at the problems, solutions. So the method 1 I've already discussed in the previous case, and even the method 2 I've already discussed in the previous case. So I'm going to discuss the method 3 here. So this third method is actually mathematical. So let me explain you how this method is working. So I'm going to assume that we have a numbers from 1 to n, and where the value of n is 5. Okay, so this is representing 1 to n. Okay, so we have numbers from 1 to 5. Now because we have numbers from 1 to 5, therefore the array that we are going to use, this array will be having a total of 7 index locations. So this is n plus 2, that is a total of 7 index locations. So let us take some random numbers, numbers between 1 to n, which is 1, 2, 4, 3, 5, 2 and 1. So here you can clearly see that two numbers are repeating. There is number 1 is repeating itself as well as number 2 is repeating itself. The problem is, can you write a program to find out these two repeating numbers? So the first solution that we are discussing here, this is the method number 3, is about creating equations. So we are going to make equations. So mathematically, we are going to solve these problems. Number 1 is, we are going to find sum of all the numbers. And second one is, we are going to find product of all the numbers, right? So here you can see, because we have a number from 1 to n. Okay, so we are going to take the sum of every number, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. So in general, if we take first n natural number, the sum is generally equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2. So here there are total of 5 numbers, so the sum should be equal to 5 into 5 plus 1 divided by 2, which is equal to 30 divided by 2, which is equal to 15. So you can also verify whether the sum is equal to 15 or not. So you can see 1 plus 2 plus 3, this is 6. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So this total sum will be actually 10, and 10 plus 5 is 15. So this is the total sum is 15. In the same way, when we find out the product, so product of 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. So this is actually equivalent to n factorial. So here we have 5 factorial. So 5 factorial is the product of these terms. In the same way, for this array, we are also going to find the sum and the product. Now here, in this array, what will be the sum? Sum will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus so it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 2 plus 1. So we have to take the sum of every number. So this entire sum, you can see in this entire sum, we are getting the first part, which is this sum of the same equation. So this entire sum can also be called as n into n plus 1 divided by 2 plus nx plus ny, where nx is a first number. When nx is a one number that is repeating itself, so this is the number that is repeating itself, and ny is the second number that is repeating itself. So there are two extra numbers that are repeating itself. In the same way, we can use the product terms, and if you find the product of every number, so product will be 1 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1, which can also be written as 5 factorial multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So we can also find product like this, right? So just use these two equations, use the sum equation and use the product equation to find one. So this equation can also be modified like this. So it can be written as n factorial multiplied by nx multiplied by ny. So these are the numbers that are repeating itself. So compare these two sums. So we are going to compare the first sum equation. We are going to take this sum equation. If you want to find out what are those numbers, then we are going to take this sum that is that we found out here. So the sum is n into n plus 1 divided by 2 plus nx plus ny. This is the sum of this array. Subtracted this value, so it is going to be n into n plus 1 divided by 2, so which is going to give us nx plus ny. Okay, so which is in this particular case is nx plus ny is 3. Now in the second case, we are going to use a division method. So division method will be n factorial multiplied by nx multiplied by ny divided by n factorial, so which is going to give us nx multiplied by ny. So here it is 2 multiplied by 1, which is equal to 2. So we got this equation, which is nx multiplied by ny, which is 2, and nx plus ny, which is equal to 3. So we can use these two equations to find out the sum of nx and ny, right? And how you can find out the sum of nx and ny? You can use the various formulas that we have. For example, if you do a plus b whole square, so that can be written as a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, so there are various formulas like this which does exist, because we know the value of a plus b whole square and we know the value of a multiplied by b. So you can find it out, a square plus b square, what is this value, and you can use that value to find out the numbers also. Okay, so this is a mathematical way that we are going to use. I hope that, I feel that most of you did not even understand what I am doing is. Let me explain it to you theoretically here, and then I am going to show you how I am going to implement the same thing in the program. So what I am going to do is, I don't know what are those numbers initially. Okay, so what they are giving us, that we have an array like this. In this array we have some numbers which are ranging from 1 to n. Right, so 1 to n is the numbers, and the size of the array is n plus 2, and there are two numbers that are repeating itself. For example, number x, number y. So this number x and y, they are repeating this themselves in this array. Other numbers can be anything. Okay, but they are not repeating themselves, but only two numbers are repeating themselves. So they are saying, let the numbers which are repeating themselves are x and y, and we make two equations for x and y. For simple task is to left the two equations. So the first case is, for this entire array, find the sum. So sum will be all the numbers, this number plus this number plus this number plus this number plus x plus y plus x plus y and so on. So you are going to find the sum. So sum will be n into n plus 1 divided by 2 plus x plus y. So this is the sum of this entire array. And second is, you find the product of this entire array. So product will be n factorial multiplied by x multiplied by y, like this. So after finding the sum, you are going to subtract these values, because our aim is to find this value of x and y, and then you are going to also going to divide them here. So subtraction, division. So you are going to get two things. One is x plus y here. So if let us say this is an example array, then we are going to get x plus y value, which is 6, and we are going to get x y value, which is 8. So we know x plus y is equal to 6, and we know x into y is equal to 8. So these are two values that we got. Now I'm just going to use this formula. So you can create your own formulas also. So if we know this x minus y formula, so x minus y is, we know x minus y whole square can be written as x square plus y square minus 2xy, right? So we know the value of xy, correct? So, and further, you can also utilize this formula. You can also write it like this, because x minus y square can also be written like this. It can also be written like x plus y whole square minus 4xy, right? So this is a very simple mathematical equation. From here only you can get this equation, because if you expand this one, you are going to get this thing only. We know the value of x plus y. So the value of x plus y here is 6 square minus 4x multiplied by y is 8, and this is x minus y whole square. So after this, you can find out the value of x minus y. Okay, so you can take the square root and you can find out the value of x minus y. Now you got the value of x plus y, you got the value of x minus y, and you can solve these two equations to find the value of x, and you can solve these two equations to find the value of y. Okay, I hope that you understood this part again, but still, if you do not understand this one, let me explain with a simple example, simple program here. So in this program, we are having this array. Okay, so this array is having some numbers, maybe 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 3, 5. Okay, and it is having all these numbers. So total index locations are 7 here. Okay, and we know that numbers are from 1 to 5. Now our aim is to find those two numbers that are repeating itself using this program. So we are going to call this function, which is void print repeating numbers. We are going to take s, that is for sum of all the numbers, that is s is for saving sum, and p is equal to 1, which is for product of all the numbers. So p is going to save product of the numbers. So and these x and y are the two repeating elements that we are assuming. Now we know the size of the array, correct? Now for every number we are going to find the sum, and we are going to find the product. From here we are going to find sum of all the elements in the array, and from here we are trying to find out product of all the elements in the array, so we know the sum of all the elements and we know the product of all the elements. Now I'm just going to use the same formula that we derived, so which is sum minus n into n plus 1 divided by 2, because what sum should be n into n plus 1 divided by 2 plus x plus y. From here, if we subtract this value, then we can just get x plus y. So this is just noting x plus y. In the same way, in product, we are going to divide by factorial. So we are going to get x multiplied by y. Okay. So from here, I'm getting x plus y. And from here, I'm getting x multiplied by y. And now I'm just trying to find out these values, which is for x and y. I'm applying this equation, as I told you in the previous video also. So I'm just using this equation, this particular equation, that is x minus y. So it x minus y can also be written as under root of x plus y whole square minus 4xy. So you can check this out. So I'm just using this equation here. From here I can find out the value of x, and I can find out the value of y, and I can just repeat it here, print those values. Now you can clearly see here I'm just using one loop. Now with the help of one loop, I can find out the sum of the entire array, as well as I can find out the product of the entire array. So solving this problem using this case is going to take order of n as the time complexity, and it is going to take order of 1 as a space complexity. So I solved the same problem with order of 1 as a time complexity, order of 1 as a space complexity, and this is very interesting, correct? So as you can see, to solve many problems in real world, we need some mathematical background. And with the help of this mathematical background, we are able to solve the problems more efficiently. Now, in the next video, I'm going to solve the same problem, but this time I'm going to use a method number 4, which is by using the XOR of these numbers. And even by using the XOR of this number, we can easily find out, how to solve this problem in order of n as a time complexity and order of 1 as a space complexity. I hope that you understood this solution. And if you did not understood, just let me know and email me, or you can comment under this video. I'll try to see and try to give you the solution of this video. Okay. And thank you for watching. Now let us move on to the next solution, which is the method number 4 to solve the same problem.